talk about how to create appropriate structure of tibia and femoral, what's called floating knees. The external structure of tibia and femoral is referred to as floating knee. May involve shaft and emphasis or articular cut surface. This is for high energy problem. Floating knee is a complex injury. It's a fracture of soft tissue and a shift injuries. It's a challenge to manage. The classification, this classification of type 1 is the physical tibia and femur, type 2 is the physical femur and the physical tibia, type 2 is the physical tibia and the physical femur, and the physical both considered as conceived. This is an algorithm for treatment of external tibia and femur management. Non-operative is considered as obsolete treatment combined. Combined treatment with etomodular femur foot and function just for the tibia, but the standard treatment is operative treatment for closed fracture is according to the site for the femur eyes are going for boxing the femur fracture, DHS of this is considered according to the type of the fracture. For shaft fracture, etomodular hearing eyes are anti-grade or hypergrade, and for supracondylar area by internal fixation by DCS or local plates. And for the tibia, according to the type of the fracture, either going to biological plate or intermodular area. For type 3, for open type 3, either doing temporary internal fixation with conversion to the internal fixation according to the type of the fracture, or doing laser fixator from the start, or combination of both. So we choose the combination, there is a high incidence of the ligamentous injury with such type of the fracture. What is the role of a laser for such type of fracture? Either primary treatment plus minimal internal fixation or treatment as a result of the complication with infected tendon or failed internal fixation or incident clearance of flammable. The 25 patients with open floating knee treated by a combination of internal fixation for the femur and a laser for the tibia. So according to the fracture type, it's type 1 in 8, type 2 in 6, and type 2B in 7, and type 2C in 4. There's a lot of associated injuries, vascular injury and compartment syndrome, infection, sports bones, and leg union, and joint stiffness. Assessment of function assessment including the subjective symptoms observation and working ability, work and sports, angulation, and rotation and deformity and the sacred joint movement. From the results, the mean follow-up was 3.4 years and the union time for the femur ranged from 15 to 21 weeks and for the tibia ranged from 18 to 27 weeks. It was considered excellent date in good and acceptable in 2 and 4 in 3. Complication including stiffness, deep infection, delayed union, and so on. It's a case presentation. First case, open fracture of femur, grade 3, and open segmental fracture tibia. Treated by the primary at intermodular neck for the femur and the lesion for the tibia. And tibia is finally mounted with minimal fixation for the proximal fracture. This is a patient very later on in the function of the femur and we graft the femur and for the aim of the tibia is united and the femur is united and this is a good range of motion. And for just two, open fracture of femur, grade 3C with vascular injury and open fracture of tibia with compartment syndrome and deep infection of the tibia, initial external fixation. And treated by laser for the femur and bone transport and eradication of the infection from the tibia. And fracture is looks united, but with early removal, the free fracture appears and intermodular again. And the patient united, and we're looking for the site, for the graph for the looking site. And we're still missing. Something slides, and at the end, the fracture is united, and we regenerate it by accordion pattern. But here the state is charged from the fracture with cosmetic fragment, excision, and we leave a helicoptical defect created by the induced osteogenesis and later on body graft after 1.5 months. And finally it's united with good range of motion. This is a case 3 with endomedullary fixation for the posterior and tibia. And this is twisted fragment. We excise this segment and do it bone transport. We transport over intermedullary wire from distal to proximal. And it's during bone transport. And here the regenerate become hypertrophic, so we decide to do graft for this hypertrophic regenerate. And finally it's united. United, the femur is united proximal and distal with good range of motion. The case 4 was open fracture for the distal femur and proximal tibia and child. So primarily we did axilla fixation till soft tissue heal, and we do later on a little and transport from proximal to distal and function with united. The patient has associated a stable fracture fixation and internal fixation. And finally the fracture heal and regenerate is good. For soft management. So we decided to do algorithm for soft tissue management. We first, according to the fracture, we use staged treatment. We go first axilla fixation, monoplanar axilla fixation is a very procedure. Then we convert it into antenna fixation. With some precautions, the second step, or according to the situation, we need plastic reconstruction as a local PDK flap or three flaps, or we decide to do a cloth shutting, or we'll consider the horizontal transverse incision, or doing composite bone and soft tissue transport, or at the end, if needed, vacuum assisted bone closure. For the staged treatment for preauricular fracture, it is a particular challenge to the orthopedic surgeon. So the embryo is gravity stabilized by external fixation divided and when necessary managed by fasciotomy. And our goal is to restore the articular surface and stabilization of the reconstructed articular surface and restoration of motion and avoidance of complication. What is the fixation options is combined with internal fixation or limited internal fixation augmented by external fixation or doing definitive external fixation from the start. The clinical dilemma is the timing of definitive fixation. We weigh the benefits against risks. With high risk of deep infection, we have to study before deciding to do internal fixation. So with four strategies, either doing safety window, we minimize the time between placement of axilla fixation and its removal, or doing safety interval, so allow the time for healing the pin sites after its removal, or treating the pin sites by debridement and antibiotics. Or modifying the fixator itself by using the neural drugs appetite coated pins or using the ring fixator. This open peritoneal femoral fracture is treated by external fixator from the start and then doing internal fixation by the locked blades and the graft, and the fracture united with good range of motion. For the physical fracture doing the same, we improved the fracture fit reduction and with severe union rates and improving the biomechanics of the fixation and increase the patient tolerance. This patient was open fracture femur and we waited the environment and the resurfacing was done. There's some missing slides there. And then doing the load and intermittent enabled circulation and bone graft. For acute shunting, for such a fracture, is a comminuted distal tibial fracture. And we decided to do acute shuttling and doing transverse incision and doing laser external fixation lengthening from the proximal cotton. At the end, the fracture was united. And this is the site of the scar for the transverse incision. Another example, for composite bond and surface transport, the strategy of Dr. Bar, this is a drawing from Dr. Bar. The transport was the bone and soft tissue. At the end, you treat the invaginated skin and you transfer the tissue and you manage the invaginated skin. This is an example from Dr. Berger, and at the start, the bone exposed and the transport is covered. At the end, what is the vacuum-assisted bone closure? It is application of topical negative pressure to move the blood and serous fluid and reduce the infection rate. It increases the localized blood flow and supplies the wound with oxygen and nutrition and promote accelerated healing. This is the shape of the vacuum system. And this is the sequence of the procedure to do water preparation, placement of the foam, and sealing with wraps and application of negative pressure. This is a case with good fixation, but with very bad skin and with sequence of events, the water becomes granulating and the bone is covered and the fixation is eradicated with antibiotic and with the vacuum system. In conclusion, this combined laser fixation for tibia and tibia fixation of the femur is a good and reliable method for treatment of open floating knee, but associated with multiple procedures and complications which need to be treated appropriately. Thank you.